Good morning and welcome. My name is Reverend Gilbert Hamm, Jr. and I'm one of the associate ministers here at Ebenezer Baptist Church. And once again, it is my pleasure to welcome you to our online worship experience. We have a special presentation for you today as we are celebrating our 92nd church anniversary. And we're so excited for the Lord's grace for allowing us to be around for 92 years. And so we're so excited for you to join us for this special occasion. And of course, I have the opportunity of introducing our pastor, Pastor Gilbert S. Hamm, Sr. He's going to be preaching a powerful message, the joy of coming to church. So I know you're going to enjoy the message and our service. So you want to go ahead and grab a friend, grab a coworker, grab a family member and let them know that the Word of God and the service is about to get started. Well, you know what time it is. Let's go. Welcome back. I truly hope that you were blessed and you were encouraged by that selection from our choir. And I've come back to just invite you to partner with us to sow a seed into the ministry. And if this ministry has been a blessing to you, then we invite you to share and partner with us. On the screen, you'll see how you can partner with us. Once again, we're so excited and thankful for your support. We're so thankful for your prayers. And we continue to pray for you and your family as you continue to pray for us and support us. God bless.
When I read the Psalms, I discover that it's about someone who really knows how to praise the Lord. David. He knew how to praise the Lord. David said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. That means no matter what I'm going through, he's still worthy of praise. Listen. I've been through the fire. I've been through the flood. Broken in pieces and left all alone. But through it all, God blessed me. Through it all, God kept me. And I still have praise inside of me. Yes, I still have a praise inside. inside of me. Lord, I thank you. inside of me. Hey, hey. Yes, I still have a praise inside of me. Hey. Yes, I still have praise inside of me. Out of me, the Lord I love, yeah. Lord I love you. Hallelujah. For your goodness and your mercy, for your goodness and your mercy, Lord I love you and I thank you. No one ever. Inside of me. Yes, I still have praise inside of me.
In spite of what I'm going through, in spite of what I'm going through, I still have a praise inside of me. Now can somebody help me give God, I still got a praise inside of me, praise. I think can somebody help me give God, I still got a praise inside of me, praise. Somebody open up your mouth and say hallelujah. Somebody say glory. Somebody say thank you, Jesus. Are you glad you still got that praise? If you don't mind, look down the pew and tell your neighbor, I still got a praise inside of me. Tell your neighbor, I'm not taking my praise back home. I'm not taking my praise back home. I'm going to get it out. If you don't mind, turn to your neighbors and neighbor, don't you take your praise back home. Tell another neighbor, don't you take your praise back home. But it's good to be here. It's good to be here in the house of the Lord. Chairman Deacon Marion Brown, Chairman Trustee John McQueen, to our official staff, First Lady Mrs. Varla Hamm, Mrs. Marlo Hamm, to the Ebenezer Baptist Church family, and to our guests. To those of you who can, will you please stand for the reading of God's Word. Still got to praise. Yes. I don't know about you, but I still got to praise. If you agree with me, let me see you wave your hand. Some hard times, but I still gotta pray. Sometimes I have to cry all night long, but I still gotta pray.
Thank you, Lord.
The road's been rough. The night's been dark, but I still gotta pray.
Yes, Lord.
I don't feel real good in my body, but I still gotta praise. And you know why I still gotta praise? Because he's worthy. He's worthy of all of our praise. Now before I give you the text, once again, look down the pew and tell your neighbor, I still got a praise. Come on, tell another neighbor, neighbor, I still got a praise. Hallelujah. Go ahead, sing. Go ahead, go ahead. I still.
Yeah.
Psalm 122, verses 1 and 2. Psalm 122, verses 1 and 2. If you have it, say amen. Amen. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. You may be seated. Father, in Jesus' name, seal this message in our hearts. For I ask it in Yeshua's name. Amen. Verse 1, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Subject of this morning, the joy of coming to church. The joy of coming to church. This psalm is called a song of degrees. It is called a song of degrees because it is one of 15 Psalms, 100, Psalm 120 through 134. Once again, this psalm is called a song of degrees. It is called a song of degrees because it is one of the 15 Psalms, Psalm 120 through 134, that fall into this classification of Psalms that were sung by Jewish pilgrims as they ascended Mount Zion on their way to worship at the temple in Jerusalem. These psalms were designed to glorify God. And these psalms were also designed as a tool to prepare the hearts of God's people for worship. In essence, these were what we call Dr. Watts. Like Dr. Watts songs that have us looking and appealing to God for help. And like Dr. Watts songs that uplift the soul and condition the corridors of our heart for worship. Songs like, Father, I stretch my hands to thee. No other help I know. Songs like, we're marching to Zion, beautiful Zion. We're marching upward to Zion, that beautiful city of God. Sounds like, this is the day the Lord hath made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Sounds like, oh God, our help in ages past, our hope for years to come. Pray with me
if you please. Amen. Now, this psalm talks about the place of worship, Jerusalem. It talks about the purpose of worship, to glorify God, and the power of worship, bringing gladness to the hearts of the worshipers. It is a song of David, who delighted in the Lord. It is a song of David, who expresses his excitement for worship in the house of the Lord. You see, David loved the Lord. And David loved to worship the name of the Lord. It was David who writes, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Verse 1. And it is David who writes, because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek thy good. Verse 9. Now within our text, notice how David begins this song with an emphasis on God's house. And notice within our text how David ends this song with an emphasis on God's house. You see, my brothers and sisters, for David, God's house was his refuge. For David, God's house was the place where he encountered the Lord, the place where he stood in God's presence, the place where he sensed God's spirit, the place where he heard God's voice, the place where he congregated with God's people. God's house. God's house. A place of praise. God's house. A place of prayer. God's house, a place of communion. God's house, a place of joy and peace. Now for David, God's house was the temple at Jerusalem. However, for us, God's house is the sanctuary of the church house. The church house where souls are revived. The church house where hearts are mended. The church house where lives are transformed. The church house where relationships are restored and fortified with God and with others. It's here. Somebody say it's here.
It's here.
It's here. In the church house, where we stand in God's presence. It's here, in the church house, where we sense God's spirit. It's here, in the church house, where we hear God's voice. is here in the church house where we congregate with God's people. The church house, a cathedral of love and grace. The church house, a community of faith and belief. The church house, a common ground of strength and comfort. The church house, a beacon light in dark times. The church house, a hospital. A hospital ward in sick times. The church house, a soothing balm in painful times. The church house, a pill of therapeutic relief in perplexing times. It's no wonder David says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Pray with me, if you please. Now, within our text, the key word is glad, which means happy and pleased. Within our text, the key word is glad, which expresses a feeling of joy and pleasure. You see, when we come to the church house, there ought to be gladness. And when we leave the church house, there ought to be a change in our lives. In other words, something on the inside of us ought to propel us to come to church. And something on the inside of us ought to happen while we have church. Something ought to happen when we hear the songs. Something ought to happen when we hear the sermons. Something ought to happen when we hear the prayers. Something ought to happen when the Holy Spirit visits the house. The old folk used to say, I went to a meeting one night and my heart wasn't right, but something got a hold of me. Well, I wish I had some prayers. Some worshipers in here. We're talking about the joy of coming to church. We're talking about the joy of church fellowship. We're talking about the joy of church service. We're talking about the joy of church unity. We're talking about the joy of church inspiration at church when we're able to lay our burdens down. There should be joy. Oh, I wish I had some worshipers in here. At church, when we're able to vocalize our intercontentment, there ought to be joy. At church, and anxieties upon the Lord, there should be joy. At church, when we are able to hear a word from the Lord, there should be joy. You see, my brothers and sisters, to hear a word that helps us, to hear a word that strengthens us, to hear a word that encourages us, to hear a word that awakens us. Do me a favor and tell a neighbor, chime in where you're fitting. If you hear a word that keeps our mind, chime in where you fit in. Oh Lord, if you hear a word that preserves our soul, chime in where you fit in. Oh Lord, if you hear a word that heals our body, chime in where you fit in. Oh Lord, to hear a word that spares our lives, spare thy life, do me a favor and tell a neighbor, chime in where you fit in. Oh Lord, listen, if you heard a word that uplifted you, if you heard a word that refuted you, if you heard a word that has excited you, if you heard a word that has let you know that you can make it, chime in where you fit in. Oh Lord, the word that says don't give up. Oh Lord, the word that says this too shall pass. Do I have any help in here? A word that said no weapon formed against thee shall prosper. Oh Lord, a word that said weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Oh Lord, no wonder David says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Oh Lord, we're talking about the joy of coming to church. Do I have any help in here? Listen, sometimes the church gets a bad rap. Oh Lord, sometimes the church is frowned upon and talked about. Sometimes the church is inundated with attacks. Oh Lord, sometimes the church is laughed at and scorned. However, for the message of the church, yeah, but for the message of the church, we'll be lost. No. However, but for the message of the church, we'll be doomed. However, but for the message of the church, we'll be comfortless. Oh Lord, however, but for the message of the church, we'll be separated from God. But we're not separated from God, no, because of the church. Oh Lord, but we're not living, oh Lord, we are not living without comfort because of the church. Do I have any help in here? But we are not doomed, oh Lord, in our sins because of the church. But we're not lost, yeah, we're not lost without guidance because of the church. No, the church is a house of salvation. Oh Lord, the church is a house of redemption. Oh Lord, the church is a house of deliverance. Do I have any help in here? The church is a house of restoration and reconciliation. do me a favor and tell somebody, thank God for the church. Oh Lord, do me a favor and tell somebody, I'm happy to be back in the church. Oh Lord, I'm happy to be here. Do I have any worshipers in here? I'm happy that I can walk in the church. Oh Lord, I'm happy that I can sit down in the church. I'm happy that even with a mask on my face, can enjoy the presence of the Lord in the house of the Lord. David said, oh Lord, David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us, not back on the lawn, but let us go into the house of the Lord. Oh Lord, listen, many lives have been saved because of the church. Oh Lord, many broken hearts have been mended because of the church. Oh Lord, many shattered souls have been revived because of the church. Many severed relationships have been restored because of the church. The church is a beacon of life. Oh Lord, the church is a haven of shelter. Oh Lord, the church is a pillar of inspiration. Oh Lord, the church is a hospital of healing. Oh Lord, do me a favor and tell somebody, thank God for the church. Do I have any help in here? Do me a favor and tell somebody, I'm happy to be back in the church. Oh Lord, I'm happy to be back in the church because I can sing in the church one more time. Oh Lord, yeah, I can shout in the church one more time. I can pray in the church one more time. I can give in the church one more time. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Listen, Ebenezer, well, since we're here, let's make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Oh Lord, well, since we're here, let's sing unto the Lord a new song. Oh Lord, well, since we're here, let's serve the Lord with gladness. Oh Lord, well, since we're here, let's enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his court with praise. The Bible says, let everything, oh Lord, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. The Bible says, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. So since we're here, let's do it. Since we're here, let's participate. Since we're here, let's turn up the volume. Since we're here, let's magnify the name of the Lord together. Tell somebody, I was saved in the church. Tell somebody, I was healed through the church. Tell somebody, I was delivered and set free in the church. Tell somebody, my life has been changed and my soul has been revived. Oh, the joy of coming to church. Oh, the joy of coming to church. Oh, the joy of being in church. Oh, the joy of being back. Oh, the joy of being here. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Well, Ebenezer, since we're here, let's get our praise on. Oh, Lord. Ebenezer, since we're here, let's worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Since we're here, let's act like we're glad to be in the house of the Lord. If you're glad to be in the house of the Lord, can you say amen? The joy of coming to church. Thank you, Lord, for giving me another chance. Come into your house. But whether you know it or not, there are many people in the hospitals wish they had your opportunity to come into the house of the Lord. I'm done, everyone standing. Saved in the church through the preaching of the late Reverend Davis. The word was preached, and God reached out and healed me. Healed me from all of my sins. Oh, how grateful I am.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
And it happened when I came to church. Somebody may be here right now. The Lord is reaching out to you. And he's saying, come and give me your heart. Come as a candidate for baptism, Christian experience, by letter or by restoration. If you're here, why don't you come? My sister, my brother, don't you worry about who's standing next to you. Please keep in mind that you must meet God for yourself.
Amen.
So if you're here, those of you who desire prayer, would you please remain standing? Those of you who desire prayer, please remain standing. I'm going to ask my wife, Mrs. Barbara Hamm, would you please come down and offer up this prayer for us. Those of you who would like to come to the altar, you may do so, or you can remain where you are. But if you desire to come to the altar, you can come before my wife prays. You can remain where you are. If you desire to come, you can come to the altar.
you bring your burdens? Why don't you bring your anxieties? Why don't you bring your fears? Bring them to the altar. Cast all of your burdens upon the Lord, because He cares for us. Jesus cares for us. Not only He cares for us, but Jesus loves us. Don't you understand, Ebenezer, that prayer changes things? Don't you understand that prayer works? If you need something from God, open up your mouth and tell Him. Yes, He's omniscient. He knows everything, but God wants you to tell Him what you want. He wants you to tell Him what you want. Ebenezer, I don't know about you, but I'm glad I serve a prayer-hearing God. I'm glad I serve a prayer-hearing God. God answers prayer. He answers prayer. And He's able to do whatever you ask Him to do. God's able. He's able to do it. I don't care what you're in. I don't care what you're facing. God is able to bring a change to that situation. He's able. I said He's able. God is able. God is able. Go ahead and bless the Lord. Go ahead and bless Him. Because nobody knows like you know what the Lord has done for you. Don't you worry about who's standing next to you. Give God the praise that He deserves. Because He brought you out. He healed your body. He deserves your praise. I said He deserves your praise. I said God deserves your praise. Let us pray for Mrs. Hamm. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come to say
in the name of Jesus.
God, we just come to say thank you for another day. My God, in the name of Jesus.
Thank you.
God, we come to let you know that we was glad when you said unto us, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem.
Yes,
and God,
Lord,
we just want to say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
God, a few of your believing children are standing around the altar, or they are standing just to say thank you, God.
Thank you.
Oh, my God, we have so many requests, oh, God. I don't know what they are, God, but you already know in the name of Jesus.
Yes, you do.
So those of us who have requests before the Lord, as you stand and as you speak to the Lord, He will hear your prayer and He will answer by and by. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. It is a day of celebration today, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Some of you can celebrate that the 92 years. You haven't been here for 92 years, but you've been here for a long time.
Yes,
and you
Lord
ought to tell the Lord thank you. Some
thank
of
you,
you got saved right here in Ebenezer, and you ought to tell the Lord thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Some of you got healed right here in Ebenezer, and you ought to tell the Lord thank you.
Thank you,
hallelujah,
Lord.
Glory be to God. Some of you was delivered right here in Ebenezer, and you ought to tell the Lord thank you. Hallelujah, glory be to God. Somebody's children was saved right here in Ebenezer,
yes,
and you ought to tell the Lord thank you. Somebody's mother, father, sister, or brother was saved in Ebenezer, and you ought to tell the Lord thank him. Hallelujah, glory
hallelujah
be to God. Somebody was blessed right here in Ebenezer, and you ought to tell the Lord thank you for blessing me to be in every need of this morning.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, my God, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. It's time to celebrate every need in the name of Jesus. And God, we thank you for the years that we've been here at every need. And we just want to say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Now, thank you, Lord. Whatever you need, tell the Lord all about it in the mighty name of Jesus, because God is here to deliver. He's here to set you free.
Yes,
in the
yes.
mighty name of Jesus, hallelujah, glory be to God. Whatever you have before the Lord, your children, your family, oh my God, just tell God thank you. Whatever it is, it's already done. And we just want to tell the Lord thank you.
Thank you.
We just want to tell God thank you for what all
yes,
he's already done. We want to thank the Lord because he's kept us here all of these years. We want to thank you, Sister Davis. The Lord kept her 90 years and she's still here. And we just want to tell God thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, my God. In the name of Jesus, we want to thank God for Sister Faith. She'll be 89 on Friday. And we want to tell God thank you. Oh, my God. In the name
yes.
of Jesus, hallelujah, glory be to God. We all have something to tell the Lord thank you for. In the mighty name of Jesus, you ought to tell the Lord thank you. Let the Lord hear from you this morning. Let the Lord hear from you this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus, tell him thank you. Oh, my God, in the name of Jesus, I want to tell God thank you this morning for my pastor this morning, oh, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, I want to thank you, choir, for praying for pastor yesterday. In the name of Jesus, prayer partners, I want you to thank you for praying for pastor yesterday because he wasn't feeling good at all this morning. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. And I just want to tell the Lord thank you this morning. Oh, my God, I wasn't sure that he was going to be able to bring forth the word this morning. But I want to tell God thank you this morning. I want to tell the Lord thank you this morning. I want to tell God thank you for healing, Pastor, this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus. Pastor, I want you to know that you are healed this morning. It might not have manifested itself yet, but you are healed. You are healed. You are healed. You are healed, and I claim it this morning. In the name of Jesus, I claim your healing, Pastor. In the name of Jesus, it's already done. In the name of Jesus, and whatever you have before the Lord, it's already done.
Thank you, God.
It's already done.
Already.
You just need to believe it. In the name of Jesus, grab hold of it, grab hold of it, grab hold of it. And don't you let go because it's already done. Those children are saved this morning. The name of Jesus, hold on to it. Oh my God, if it's on the job or if it's in the family, whatever it is, just hold on to it,
yes,
knowing
Lord.
That the Lord has done that just for you because you belong to him. In the name of Jesus, oh God, we thank you. Oh my God, we just want to say thank you this morning, Jesus.
Yes,
hallelujah, glory be to God. We got to learn how to tell the Lord thank you.
Thank
and
you.
We, oh my God, we just need to learn how to tell the Lord thank you.
Thank
and
you.
Oh my God, we just need to learn how to tell the Lord thank you.
Thank you.
We just need to learn how to tell the Lord thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
We need to learn how to tell the Lord thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus, hallelujah, glory be to God. Oh God, I want to thank you for all of those who are standing, oh God. I want to thank you for all of those who are at the altar this morning, oh God.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus, because we know that you will answer prayer, oh God, because you are prayer answering, God. You are prayer answering, God. And I just want to say thank you.
Thank you.
I want to celebrate and tell the Lord thank you. I just want to celebrate this morning and tell the Lord thank you, because everything that I have before you, God, I know you're going to do it because you're promising in your word. Oh, my God, you're promising. The choir saying you're promising, oh, God, and whatever you promise, God, you will bring it to pass.
Oh,
in
yes.
the mighty name of Jesus, hallelujah, glory to God. Oh, my God, so let's celebrate our healing. Let's celebrate our
yes,
deliverance.
Yes.
Oh, my God, let us celebrate. Oh, my God, let us celebrate this
yes.
morning, oh, God. Let us celebrate, let us celebrate, let us celebrate along
yes.
with 92 years. And let us celebrate our healing. Let us celebrate everything that the Lord has done for you. Let's celebrate that the Lord saved us. Hallelujah. Glory
yes,
be to
Lord.
God. Let us celebrate that the Lord saved us. Hallelujah. Glory
hallelujah.
Be to God. Let us celebrate that the Lord saved you. He might have said,
save you on a Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday. But you ought to celebrate, or Saturday. But you ought to celebrate that the Lord saved me.
Yes, Lord.
Glory be to God. Thank you, God.
Glory.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We thank you, God. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I was glad. 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 I was so glad to come into the house of the Lord. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. I was glad. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, and God, we thank you for healing. We thank you for deliverance. We thank you for setting us free, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord Jesus, that we have a church that we can come to, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, we thank you for a state and a country that we live in, that we can go and worship you, Lord, because somebody in some other country cannot go and worship you freely, oh God. But we thank you that we can worship you, oh God. Oh, in yes. The mighty name of Jesus, we thank you that we can come together and worship you, God.
Yes.
And give you praise and give you glory and give you honor, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, now, every knee will just tell God, thank you. Every knee will just tell the Lord, thank you. Oh my God, and mean it from your heart. Just tell God, thank you. Hallelujah, glory be to God. Tell the Lord, thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus, hallelujah. Oh my God, I want to thank you this morning, oh God, for bringing Sister Johnson home, oh God. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord. God, I want to thank you because you still got your hand on Sister Vivian Smith, and I want to say thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, glory be to God, because I believe, oh God. Thank you for Sister Cooper, oh God. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah, glory be to God. Trustee Woodson, oh God, thank you, Jesus. Oh my God, Trustee Edwards, oh God, in the name of Jesus, we pray for them, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, hallelujah, glory be to God. Oh my God, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, God.
God bless you. Thank you, Sister Hamm, for that fervent prayer. Go believing that the Lord has heard your petition, and your answer is on the way. Amen. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you, Sister Hamm, for that very fervent prayer. Amen. The Lord is at work. The Lord is at work. Amen. Thomas of Ebenezer, it's giving time.
Welcome back. I truly hope that you were blessed and that you were encouraged by that message from our pastor. And if you were blessed and encouraged, then we simply ask that you just leave us a comment and let us know how the Word of God has impacted your life. If you've never accepted Christ as your personal Savior and you would like to do so, say this prayer with me. Dear Lord Jesus, I come to you confessing that I am a sinner. I come to you to confessing that you're the only one who can save me. And I'm inviting you into my heart. I believe that you died on the cross just for me. And I accept your free gift. Please save me. Ladies and gentlemen, if you said that prayer sincerely, then the Bible lets us know that you're saved. For Acts 16:31 says, "And they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved, and thy house." And so your next step is you want to go ahead and get connected to a Bible-believing and Bible-preaching church so that you can grow in your faith. We invite you to stay connected with us. We're on social media, on Facebook, at EBC Wilmington. And why don't you go ahead and click that follow button. We're also on YouTube at Ebenezer Baptist Church of Wilmington, Delaware. And why don't you go ahead and click that subscribe button, as well as the notification button so that you're notified each time we upload new content. You can also follow us by hashtag EBC Wilmington. So once again, we want to thank you so much for being a part of this worship experience. And if you're ever in the area, we do invite you to come and worship with us. We're at 2200 North Claymont Street here in Wilmington, Delaware. And we'd be so excited to come and to have you and your family to worship with us. So on behalf of Pastor Hamm, our official staff, family and friends of Ebenezer Baptist Church, we say thank you. Thank you for celebrating our 92nd church anniversary with us. We invite you to please continue to keep us in prayer as we will continue to pray for you. Until next time, take care, stay safe, and God bless.